Hi friends, this is Shiva. Welcome to Database Testing Session 6. Please subscribe my channel before watching. Okay, today we are going to discuss about numeric functions, string functions and date functions in Oracle. So for that we are going to write some SQL queries to execute these concepts. So basically when you are going to talk about numeric functions, there are three important functions we will use frequently. The first one is floor, then sale, then absolute, right? So whenever we talk about floor, it will convert the fractional number to a lower bound, right? So I will show you the example where it will convert. So for example, I have one select one value. For example, I want to write floor, right? Floor of, I have some value. For example, I have 17.99, right? So from dual, so dual is a system table where we can execute some simple select queries to understand the concept, right? So don't worry about this table and number of columns and data, just this is the system table. It will help us to execute some simple commands, right? So when you write floor of 17.99, if you execute this, what will happen is it won't convert into 18. As I told you, it will convert into lower bound. It won't convert into 18 because you may think that mathematically it must convert into 17.99 into 18. No, it won't convert, right? So that's what, that floor always it will convert into lower bound. Okay, so the same time if I use this to sail, so this is upper bound, so now it is 18. For example, if you have 17.25 also, it will be converted into 18. So here, so now mathematically also it has not crossed the 0.5 or more than 0.5, but still it is converting into that upper bound, right? So sale always upper bound, floor always the lower bound. So then what is the use of absolute? For example, if I convert sale to ABS, so for example, if I have any negative number, that is converted into positive number. So the negative number will be converted into positive number using the absolute function, right? So these are the three use of using mathematical functions in our database testing. We will maximum we will use these three functions to use, right? So now we are going to see some string functions. The first one is concatenation, right? So here when we select star from employees, so I will show you that data. So here it has first name, last name, email, phone number, hire date, job ID, salary, these columns. So now what I want to do is just I want to concatenate this first name with the last name, right? So I will write one simple function. So select concat of, if you write first underscore name comma, you can write last underscore name from employees, right? So you here now when you execute this query, it will be converted the first name last name into the single. So here you can able to see here that title concat of, it's giving the query. So now I want to give alias for the column name. So if you want, you can give column name as the employee name, right? So now if you want to give the space between first name and last name, what we can do is, so now really if you want to give the space between first name and last name, so you can give concat of, I want to write some inner concatenation, so you can give the space and you can close, then you can put comma. So now what will happen is, first it will execute this inner concatenation, first name specified with the space, then the outer concatenation with the last name. When you execute this, automatically it will give the space between first name and last name, right? So you can execute here, you can able to get first name space with the last name. So this is the way you can segregate the first name with the last name. You can use the concatenation, simple concatenation, as well as complicated things also we can do with the concatenation. Anyhow, this is not going to affect the table data, just we are retrieving the data and we are modeling, we are changing some things and we are seeing the original data, right? So now lower, for example, if you have select lower of first name from employees, right? So that names will be converted into lower case. So the same thing, if you want to change it, right, upper, automatically the values are changed into upper cases, right? This is what this lower and upper will convert into the characters. Then L trim, see, for example, I have one select statement, select some spaces, then Jack, right, from dual. So I want to give the name of the column, so just I will give name. So when you execute this, there is some space between, so there is some name, but there is some space with the name. So when you talk about L trim, so wherever there is a leading spaces, like, so here there are some leading spaces, now I want to remove, so you can write L trim, right? So you can use this L trim function to remove the leading spaces. At same time, if I have space in the trailing spaces, right, so I will use the same query, just I want to make the space between the after the Jack, like some leading spaces, trailing spaces. So I want to change L to R. So now that spaces will be removed, right? So this is the way we can use the L trim. So any of these things also is not going to affect the table data, just it will remove the space and it will show the data, right? So now there's one important function called substring. See, for example, just I will write select first name, so first underscore name from employees, right? So now I want to extract some text from the name. For example, in the first name I want to write substring of, anyhow that index is going to start from first position, so if you take the example of Nina, N is the first index, the second index is E, third index is E, then fourth index is the N, then fifth index is A. So I want to take the first index, from first index then up to the third character, from three characters. When you execute this, what happened? Substring is invalid. Okay, so it must be the substr, right? So now what will happen, it will take the first index, then from the first index it is taking the three characters, like that. If you are not giving this, this is optional, if you want to give three, so what will happen, so it will start from the third index, then we are not mentioning the number of characters, so it will take all the characters. If none of the name having the third index, then automatically that will be taken care of, modified as the null, right? So don't worry about those stuffs. So that substring syntax is that column name, then that index starts with, then number of characters, right? So from the third index I am taking the two characters, right? So this is the way we can use the substring function, right? Then length, so automatically if you take select length of, right, so length of first name, if you write first underscore name from employees, if you execute this, automatically it will give the length of each and every column. So if you want to give the alias name for the column, you can give length. So now this column name will be replaced. This length of first name will be replaced with length. If you execute this, yes, it will be changes to length of then that each and every name length. For example, if you want to see the name also, yes, if you give first name comma length. So here if you can able to see first name then length then second name then the now 5 characters, next 3 characters, like that we can see the length of the each and every column values, right? Okay, then NVL. So this is special functionality. So if you see select star from employees, if you see here there is a bonus column. In that bonus column there are some employees having bonus, then other employees is not having bonus, right? So if those who are not having bonus, those values are filled by null values, right? So now I want to replace that null values by zero. See, wherever I see null, I want to replace zero, right? So how I can modify? You can for example, if I select first underscore name comma last underscore name, now I want to have salary, then salary comma, then I want to write bonus. Let me execute this query first. From employees, so here employees. So now you can able to see there are some employees not having the bonus. Now I want to replace that bonus by zero. So you can use this NVL function to replace null with the some value. So if you give zero, automatically both values are filled with zero values. So here you can give the bonus, right? So now there is some question, right? So now I want to replace the zero with the some characters. See, for example, I want to write not applicable, right? So if you execute this, it will give the error. Why? Because when we talk about employees bonus column, it is a numeric data type. You are trying to replace this numeric data with the character type. So what you want to do is you want to convert this to character type. So you can give to care of bonus. So now if you execute this, now those values filled by NA, because now this totally this bonus column is converted into character type for displaying purpose. Then we are replacing zeros by the NA, right? So this is the way we can use the not up now that NVL function. This two number function, for example, there is a column which contains numeric values, but that column values data type is string. We can convert into two number. Yes, anyhow, I will show you one more demo for this. Just I told you the example. Here I will show you the two number function. So toCar function, see here we have used to toCar function to convert the column value to character type. So there's a date function also. We can use this toCar function where we can use you can write select there is a higher date, right? So I want to write select first name comma last underscore name, then higher date. So here if you one second, just let me execute this query so that I will get the column values. So here you can see higher underscore date, right? So from you can write employees, right? See here, now there is a date. Now I want to take that date part, month part and year part also. So what we need to do is we can write toCar of I want to write date part, right? So you can write DD. So it will give you a numeric date value. So you can write, so here I want to give higher date. Then if you want to make it the same to month also, you just copy and you can put it here. You can change this to month. So here you can make it as hired month. So this must be passed, right? Hired month. Then I want to make that as the hired year. So hired date, you can give 4y. So here you can change to hired year. So what will happen is this tocar function is extract the date part from the data. So if you change these two, hired year, hired date and hired month, right? So here if you see hired date, hired month and hired year, so if you execute this query, you will get hired date, hired month and hired year. So if you make it so for example, if you give only 3 characters, then it will give only 3 characters. So if you want to get the numeric value, you can change it to mm. So this will give you numeric value. See, for example, in this 4y, if you replace with the double c, then okay, additionally one b has joined. So this will give you the cc means century. So we are in 20th century, so it will give you the 2087. Otherwise if you give two things also, two characters also, it will give you 87. If you give double y, so this also we can able to do. So so this is what we can able to do that, right? Okay, okay. So this is what we can able to do with the tocar function, so that it will get the date part from the data, right? So the next function is system data. So if you want to get a system date, you can write select sysdata, sysdate from dual. So this will give you the system date, right? So toDate function. See, for example, how we can use toDate function. We can write select, so there is some string like 12 and December, right? So it must be 2018 from dual. So this is the date string, right? So here I will give that column value as the date string. So I will give date string. If you execute this, it will give some value. So this is not the date. Now I want to convert this as the data, right? So how I can convert? See, when we talk about Oracle data type, so DD, then MON, then year, then only it will, then only that Oracle will consider this as the data. How we can convert? So for that, we are going to use a toDate function. Then we need to give the format of the string. See, for example, here I have DD, then that I'm giving the whole month because December is a full one, then it has 4 characters of year. So now if you execute this, this is the what, the date format not recognized. We'll check with the things to date of, so DD, let me check with the, okay, so that's not the problem. So here we should give the YYYY, otherwise capital YYY. So now it must take, so now that it taken as the 12/12/2018, so now it is considering as the date. So this is what, when there is a string which is not following the Oracle date format, if you know the format of the string, we can able to convert using the toDate function. So now if you want to take the month of the this data. So took care of, you can write took care of here. If you want to give the full month also, you can able to get, that's not an issue from the data. So it will give you the December. So this is the way we can get the month from the, we can convert string to date. From the date we can process the part of part from the date. So now add months. So now I want to do something. So from the system date we'll do it from here. So here there is a method called add months. So here from the system date I want to add 2 months, right? So here if you put 2 months, so the system month is now September, so October, November. So this will give you the November month. So if you see here 11 means November, right? So months between. So here now if you write months underscore between, so if you write sysdate comma this one, so now what will happen is months between, what is that, sysdate, something was happened. Okay, from second we'll go back. Okay, now what I want to do is here I want to write months underscore between. Okay, it is giving the syntax, so now I don't want that syntax. Okay, months between, here I want to give sysdate comma add months of 2, so it must give the 2, right? So minus 2 because it's starting from the this month, right? So it must give you, it must have the future date first, then the current date, then it will give the positive value. So if you want to convert into a positive value, you can give ABS of, so automatically it will be converted into positive value. So this is what I wanted to show to here. So here we have used multiple functions of date, system date, add months, months between, then finally absolute, right? So these are the functions we can use during our testing. So we have learned now different methods today. We have started with the floor, sale, absolute, concatenation, lower, upper, L-tree. So these are the functions I have given the demo. You can go through it and you can practice it, right? Hope you like this video. So next video I will discuss about aggregate functions, right? So hope you like this video. So help others by subscribe and like and share this video. Thanks for watching.